Hi everyone, I'm Haley Carmody, and I'm doing my educational giant report on Richard Rorty. Richard Rorty was born on October 4th, 1931 in New York City. He attended the University of Chicago when he was only 15 years old and received both his bachelor's and his master's degrees. Rorty then attended Yale University and received his PhD in philosophy of mind and analytic philosophy. He then went on to teach at different universities until he retired in 2005. Rorty died on June 8, 2007 from pancreatic cancer. Rorty's contribution to the educational world was that he suggested that it is better to focus on where someone can question their own beliefs and challenge them, which means that he thought it was better for students to learn from experience than being told this is true and this is not true. This idea was known as neopragmatism. He believed that students should experience firsthand their own knowledge. He believed that teaching and education should be individualized. He wanted students to learn from questioning and experimenting for themselves to find the truth. He said, "There is truth beyond hypothesis." He believed that the best way for students to become prepared for citizenship and the changing reality throughout their lifetime was to have the ability to question and experiment and really search out the truth behind their own beliefs. The world is constantly changing, and the reality is changing throughout time. He states that the world does not speak, only we do. By learning to question what we believe, we gain experience and understanding that we would have never have received any other way. And I really like that he said that, mainly because it is true. We are the ones that make the world what it is. We're the ones that question, is this right or is this wrong? And the world and the reality wouldn't be anything if we didn't have all those questions. I think that's the greatest impact that he could have left, you know, teaching us that it's okay to question things, because school's all about learning. And most of the time we don't learn things through experience. We're just told that this is what happened. But it's nice to know that it's okay to question things, because some of the greatest lessons in life is learned through simple questions and through doing certain things. And without feeling confident that it's okay to ask questions, we may all fail. Teaching methods today have become more of a hands-on philosophy. There's belief that if students can experience, then they will remember and learn from it. Taking notes and listening to lectures is what school used to be all about, but now it's more about doing experiments and really searching out and doing more hands-on activities instead of just sitting there and taking notes and carrying around heavy textbooks all the time. You know, especially in college, you see teachers lecturing about their own experiences that they had. It's not what happened in this past. It's about things that are happening in the present and what they have learned from it. And they're teaching us through experiences that they had. And I think that's the greatest way that we can learn. We often have to learn through our own experiences instead of someone else's experiences. Group activities are more popular in school today than they were back then, because teachers are starting to see that kids really do learn better when they learn from their peers, because they're questioning their own beliefs and questioning others' beliefs, and there's just this connection that kids don't get if they're learning from a teacher. Test questions are now more based on about real life experiences, and it's interesting because before it was just, let's take the test just to solve the problems, just to prove that we knew. We never really thought that there was real-world context in it. But now with problems being about the real world around us, we really start paying attention and really truly start to understand the knowledge that we have gained, and we're able to apply it in our life later. Getting to view the outside world and experience problems firsthand was a major learning experience for me. During my senior year of high school, I got to do an internship at a hospital, and the internship program was designed to give students a look at possible careers and the challenges that they might face in all these different career paths. So every other day, I would check out for 2 class periods and go to my internship, and this was the first time I ever experienced hands-on in my own learning. I was watching the x-ray technicians do scans one day and was asking them questions about what they were looking for. And I remember one day that they gave me a chance to see if I could spot what was wrong with one of the patients' scan. So I was able to apply my human anatomy skills that I learned to this real life problem. So the x-ray technician said I did a really good job for just being a senior in high school. Granted, I'm not perfect at it, so I didn't see everything, but that's what they're there for. So it's interesting to see that in a hospital setting, someone was always questioning his or her belief every minute, because things are constantly changing, different diagnostics within minutes of each other. It was interesting because as I was talking to these nurses, they always told me that it's always okay to question what your first thought was, because it could change within a matter of minutes. And I think that's really important because sometimes we feel like we should question our first thought, but most of the time we don't, because we feel like we'll be wrong if we second guess our first thoughts. But most of the times we should always listen to that second thought, because most of the time that second thought is right. Richard Rorty's teachings blessed many students and teachers' lives to this day, teaching us that it's okay to ask questions and challenge our own beliefs and really search out that truth for ourselves to gain our own knowledge and our own experience of something is very important. I have been personally affected by the influences of Richard Rorty. I now have an understanding of just how important it is to let students experience things hands-on and let them question their own abilities and their own learning. Richard Rorty has provided the basic knowledge on how to do all these things. His teachings have been a great blessing to all the students and teachers out there, and his teachings will continue to be held in high regard to this day.